Bedford, Nova Scotia. I want to tell you kind of about a few things that I've seen on TV on our pay movie channels or movie networks or HBOs or whatever we have. We seem to have a lot of them. Got around to watching that movie Salt that debuted last week on our channel with Angelina Jolie, and I really enjoyed it. Now, I guess I like Angelina Jolie in those roles, those action roles, the Lara Croft, the Mr. and Mrs. Smith, because there's just something about her. And Wanted. Oh, I love that movie, Wanted. The insouciance is the expression, I think, that comes to my mind, basically, like, I don't care, I'm going to do this, I'm good at this, whatever, you know. She was just wonderful, and she and her stunt doubles, whatever the case may be. And I like popcorn movies like that. Every once in a while, that's what I want. And this was like 11:30, and I said, why don't I put this on? We had it on the DVR there. I didn't go to bed till 4 to 2. I liked it. I mean, it was not something that was difficult to figure out by any means. I picked out Liev Schreiber from the beginning, Leo, as being, oops. Anyway, I really enjoyed it. I must say, I highly recommend it. It's not anything more special than other movies, but it had, you know, the car chases were fine. The sets were very good. The acting was fine. You know, it was all in keeping with what it was. And, yeah. Enjoy it. Now, what else did I see lately? Game of Thrones was very good. So now we've got 2 episodes under our belt. And, oh my God, the conniving. It just, as I said in another show, video, it reminds me of Rome, as far as, of course, all the behind the throne sort of duplicity and all of that sort of stuff. So, and you've got Lena Headey, or Headey, from, oh my goodness, what was she in? Sarah Connor Chronicles, the Terminator Sarah Connor Chronicles TV show. And she's so bad. I mean, not bad acting, a bad person. You know, so of course, we love watching that. When you've got a woman behind the throne acting badly, that's great literature and that's great drama, because that's history, isn't it? Isn't that Livia from I, Clodius? Clodius? But I'm really enjoying her, and Sean Bean, of course, and the rest of them. And Peter Dinklage, my God, he's got the role of a lifetime. These pearls of wisdom rolling off his tongue. It's wonderful. So I highly recommend that one, Game of Thrones. It's complicated, and I'm not going to read the books. So it takes a while to understand who's doing what to whom. But lots of sex, be prepared, lots of rear ends, you know, lots of tits. And what else? I can't remember everything I've seen. That's terrible. But I wanted to get those two off my chest. And then I wanted to show you, I talked about this in my Titanic video. And this is, I just had coffee in it. And I said that I bought them on sale at the Titanic store in Halifax over a decade ago, when Titanic, the movie, was, you know, still bringing a lot of tourists to Halifax. And you can see that part is actually cut off, like the flake's supposed to be taller than that, and that was a printing mistake. That was bright red when I got them, but we put them through the washer. Some of them don't even have them anymore. But nice soup bowls, coffee cups, whatever. And I think, I did my pickups last week, a few of them. And this is one that, and of course now it's on our pay TV channel this week. So I was waiting to see that when the kids are all right. That's Blu-ray, $15. So that was pretty good. And I picked up the DVD version of these two movies. This is my Blu-ray of Star Trek 2 and Star Trek 4. because as I said in one of my videos about the contest, I'm not giving away that Blu-ray if I get less than 5 entrants, and I have 1 entrance to that Star Trek contest. So I will give away the DVD, but I'll keep the Blu-ray for myself. I mean, it's not right. So I'm looking forward to seeing that someday. And anything else? I got that. And that. I feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh yeah, I got a Vita, that's right. Yeah, I finally got my copy of it. Okay, Michael from Red Chair Diaries.